Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll show you how easy it is to open and save Excel files in an Angular spreadsheet component. First, I'll open my existing project, where I have already installed the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular spreadsheet package and configured all the necessary spreadsheet modules. Then, open the app component HTML file and added basic code for rendering the spreadsheet, and assign the inventory list object to the datasource property. Also, I have created a spreadsheet instance and applied bold and center formatting to the header row. You can refer to our Angular spreadsheet getting started video to learn more about adding a spreadsheet to an Angular application. I've shared the link in the card above and in the description below. Let me run this example and show you the initial output of this code. As you can see, the spreadsheet is rendered with the provided JSON data. To import a file into the spreadsheet, you can use the Open option in the File menu. Using the Save As option, you can export the spreadsheet. Now, let's see how to enable these options in the spreadsheet programmatically. First, I am going to import the spreadsheet using APIs. To do that, I need to enable the AllowOpen property and call the Open API hosted in the service URL. By default, the AllowOpen property is enabled in Spreadsheet. So, I add the Open URL property and assign the Syncfusion service URL. When I click the Open option and choose a file, the selected file is imported into the spreadsheet. Next, I will show you how to load an Excel file initially on spreadsheet using the open method. First, I open the app component TS file. In the onCreate method, I specify an online URL to fetch the Excel document and convert it to a blob. Then convert the blob into a file and pass it as an argument to the spreadsheet's open method. Look here, the spreadsheet loads the Excel file large data initially. Next, I will show you how to save the spreadsheet to Excel using an API. To do that, I need to enable the AllowSave property and call the Save API hosted in the service URL. By default, the AllowSave property is enabled in spreadsheet. So, I add the Save URL property and assign the Syncfusion service URL. Now, I can save the file using the Save As option in the File menu. Here, you can save the file in different file formats such as XLSX, XLS, CSV, and PDF. I choose the XLSX format and provide the file name Large Data. See here, the exported file is saved in the local folder. Following that, I will demonstrate how to save the spreadsheet using the built-in save method. So, I include a button tag and provide the content as save. Then, add the class name eButton to apply Syncfusion button styles to this button. And I add the inline style with margin 5 pixels. As I said earlier, I save a file with a button click. So, I add a click event with the callback method button click. In the app component TS file, define the button click method. Inside this method, I call the built-in save method using the spreadsheet instance. To this method, I add the URL property and assign the save API from the Syncfusion service URL. And set the file name as save data. As I mentioned earlier, files can be saved in XLSX, XLS, CSV, and PDF formats. I set the save type as PDF. Now, when I click the Save button, the spreadsheet data is exported to a PDF document. Next, I will show you the server-side configuration to open and save spreadsheets. So, I open Visual Studio 2022. choose an ASP.NET Core Web API project and name it as Spreadsheet Application. Here the .NET 7.0 framework is selected by default. Proceed to create the project. Once the project is created, open the NuGet Package Manager. Search for Syncfusion EJ2 Spreadsheet ASP.NET Core and click Install. This package will allow us to use the spreadsheet component in our project. The installation may take a few seconds, so please wait. Next, I search the Syncfusion XLSIO Renderer.NET Core package and click Install. This package will allow us to save the spreadsheet in different file formats. Again, please wait for a few minutes for the installation to complete. Then, I create a web API controller called Sample. Here, import the Syncfusion EJ2 spreadsheet. Then define the open method to convert Excel files into a client-side spreadsheet model, which is then sent as JSON to render the spreadsheet. Next, define the save method and the client-side spreadsheet model is sent to the server as JSON, where it will be processed and saved. I run this application. Now the project is successfully compiled and I can test the APIs to ensure they are functioning as expected. In my Angular project, I will use the hosted web API links in the open URL and save URL. When I refresh the sample, spreadsheet will try to import the large data file using the created event. So, the debugger hits the open method. The large data file is imported. When I try to save the file, the debugger hits the save method and the spreadsheet will be exported to Excel. Finally, I will show you how to send custom parameters to the server using the before save event. Here, assign the callback method onSave. I define the callback method in the app component TS file. Inside this callback method, I can pass the custom parameters to the server. Here I pass the format CSV. In the core project, change the save API method by adding the custom parameter to receive the details sent from the client side. Check now, when I save the spreadsheet in CSV file, with the name testing data, the debugger hits the save method and the custom parameters are received in the server. Let's recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to open and save Excel files in an Angular spreadsheet, and also to open an Excel file on initial load, set up a server, and send custom parameters. You can download this working example from the GitHub link given in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our Angular products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.